And now we will learn how to record receiving advance payments from clients. These are also called job deposits. Receiving advance payments from clients will result in several things in your QuickBooks records. Client reports will show money owed to clients until we actually invoice them. The accounts receivable account in the chart of accounts, also called the trial balance, will temporarily be inaccurate until you bill the client. If you make financial statements before the client balance becomes positive, your accountant can easily make a quick accountant adjustment to make the report accurate until the client is billed. If you receive a payment from a client before an invoice is made, QuickBooks will ask you to print a credit memo for the client. We have already changed the words on the credit memo to read deposit receipt. We did that in the earlier videos of this course. For example, let's imagine on January 25th, we made estimate number 3 for Kirschbaum for the Southwoods Road job. Let's imagine we put 50 units of carpentry, $66 each, 50 units of electrical work, $77 each, 50 units of mason work, $88 each, and 50 units of steam cleaning, $55 each. These are the things that we will put on the estimate and save it, and then after that, we will immediately take a deposit from Kirschbaum. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Estimate. Notice QuickBooks remembers it's estimate number 3. The date of the estimate is January 25th. So let's go forward to January 25th of 2017. The job and client is Kirschbaum, but specifically the Southwoods Road job. Now, let's read off the items: carpentry, electrical, mason, and steam. Carpentry, electrical, mason, and steam. Okay, now let's put in the quantity. 50 of each. Well, that should be easy to remember. 50, 50, 50, and 50. Okay, now we'll put the cost each. 66, 77, 88, and 55. 66. Don't worry about the price level message. 77, 88, and 55. Notice the entire estimate is $14,300. So now that we have successfully made the estimate, let's click Save and Close and confirm that the estimate has been recorded under Kirschbaum in the Southwoods Road job by looking at the report Estimates by Job. Now the interesting part happens. On the same day that we make the estimate, January 25th, we receive check number 72 from Kirschbaum for the Southwoods Road job, $5,000. QuickBooks will ask you to print a credit memo at the minute you record this payment because we have no open invoices for the Southwoods Road job. The credit memo is the deposit receipt that we made in video number 1 at the beginning of this video series. From the icon bar, click Payment. The date that we received the payment is January 25th of 2017. The person whom we received the payment from is Kirschbaum, but it is specifically for the Southwoods Road job. Check number, I believe it was check number 72. 72. Now, the money amount was $5,000. At the moment we push tab, QuickBooks has nothing to apply the $5,000 to because we have not yet made any invoices for this particular job. When we click Save and Close, QuickBooks will ask us to print a credit memo, and that will basically be the deposit receipt for Kirschbaum for the Southwoods Road job. When we click Print Credit Memo, we have the option of either physically printing it from a printer or just previewing it on the screen. Because this is a video, I'm going to click Preview, and you can see it says Deposit Receipt. And when you click here, you can see whatever other details you would normally put on the deposit receipt when you customized it at the beginning of this course, when you made a deposit receipt from a basic credit memo. This is managing the document templates, and you can explore and experiment with changing your document template on your own time. To get out of this view of seeing the deposit receipt and go back to QuickBooks, look at the top left corner of your keyboard and hit the Escape key. Okay, then you can just click Cancel for regular printing and the transaction has been recorded. Now let's take a look at the results in the customer reports. When we look at the customer balance detail, we can see that the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum has a negative balance. A negative balance means that we owe them for future service. When you look at the open invoice report, the payment will show up here. The reason a payment shows up on open invoice is because it has not yet been applied to any invoice. And in our case, we cannot apply it yet because we have not yet made any invoices for the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. And now we will invoice the client. January 30, made invoice number 6 for the Southwoods Road job. On this invoice, we're going to declare that we did 20% of the entire job. At the moment we make the invoice, we will immediately apply the past payment to the invoice. From the icon bar, click Invoice. Notice QuickBooks remembers that we're up to invoice number 6, and if not, you could always change this to invoice number 6. The date of the invoice is January 30, and the client and job is the Kirschbaum job on Southwoods Road. Notice, as soon as we choose the Kirschbaum job on Southwoods Road, we get this window, Available Estimates, and that was the estimate that we made earlier. It's the only one to choose, so we're going to click on it and then click OK. And at the moment we click OK, we get this message, Create Progress Invoice Based on Estimate. We're not billing the client for 100% of the job. We have to click here, Create Estimate for a Percentage of the Entire Estimate. Click in the box and put 20 because 20% is the amount that we finished of the entire estimate, and only 20% should go on this invoice. When we click OK, we notice that QuickBooks adjusted the quantity accordingly because the quantity of 10 is 20% of the entire 50 quantity on the original estimate. So the money amount of this invoice, you might not be able to see it, but the money amount of this invoice is $2,860. Now, before we save it, we have to go up here in the ribbon, make sure the main tab is selected, and click the command that says Apply Credits. Okay, now you have to save this before you continue. Do you want to record? Just click Yes, and we get the Apply Credits window. Notice there's only one credit available in the amount of $5,000, and it was credit number, it was from their check number 72. If there were several credits, you would click on the appropriate credit that you're applying to this particular invoice. But because there's only one credit from that payment on the 25th, QuickBooks automatically placed the check mark there. So we will agree, and we will click Done at the bottom of the window, and then click Save and Close. By the way, After you click done, notice the balance due. I don't know if you can see it, but the balance due goes down to zero, and it says paid at the minute we save this invoice. Now when we look at the open invoice report, the payment is still open on the open invoice report, but the amount of the payment open is the remainder of the $5,000, $2,140. We could always double click and see that the payment was $5,000 and $2,860 was applied to invoice number 6. Close it out. We can also look at the customer balance detail, and we can notice that the balance on the Southwoods Road job back on the 25th was $5,000. Then we did some work, which was supposed to be dated January 30th. Save and close. Yes. And then you could see on January 30th, the balance went down to $2,140. You might not have to change the date. Something's going on with my computer, because we originally recorded this as the January 30th. So you can see the balance becomes less negative on the day that we make an invoice.